Hey guys, and welcome to Diagraphics. Today I want to show you how to draw this skull inside Adobe Illustrator. So for this project we want to use the grid. So go to View, go to Show Grid, then go to View again and Snap to Grid. And to make the Snap to Grid more precise, go to the Transform panel, and if you don't have it, you can go to Window and go to Transform right here. Now go to this menu right here and make sure Align New Object to Pixel Grid is turned off. This will make Snap to Grid way more precise. Now select the ellipse tool and draw a circle in one of these squares right here. And you can zoom in a little bit. Select the ellipse tool again and draw another circle from the corner right here and make another one in the opposite side. This is the cheeks of the skull. Now we want to create the jaw. So go to the rectangle tool and draw a rectangle between the small circles. Select all the shapes. Go to the Pathfinder panel, and once again, if you don't have it, you can find it in the top of the screen in the Window menu. Now click Unite. From here you can unselect the fill and select the stroke and make the stroke a little bit wider. Go to the Stroke menu and select Round Cap and Round Join. You can also color the stroke if you want. I will give it a dark gray color. If you want to use my swatches, you can download them down in the description. To load them in, you can go to this menu right here, open Swatch Library, other libraries, and find them on your computer to load them in. Now we want the jawline to curve a little bit. For this, choose the ellipse tool again and draw a circle on top of the skull. With the arrow keys, notch it down one time. Then select all the shapes, go to the shape builder tool, hold down the Alt key to get the minus sign to subtract from the shapes, and subtract these corners right here. Now you can select the circle you used for shape building and delete it. We don't need that anymore. Now this is the basic shape of the skull, so now we need to add the details of the face. So choose the ellipse tool again and draw two eyes like this. Select both the eyes and make them a fill instead of a stroke. Right now the eyes are too close to each other, but we will correct that later. Now choose the line tool, draw three lines like this. Select the lines and make the lines the same width as the skull. Go to the Stroke menu, select Round Cap and Round Join. Now select all the shapes, go to the Shape Builder tool, and while holding down the Alt key, subtract the excess lines. To create the nose, we want to use the Line tool again, and draw a nose from here to here. You can make the nose a little bit wider. Now zoom in on the face. To make the face a little more detailed, go to the Width tool right here, and adjust the nose and the teeth like this. Now select the nose and the teeth, go to Object and select Expand Appearance. This will make all the strokes into a shape instead. So now we don't need the grid anymore. So go to View and unselect Snap to Grid. Then select one of the eyes, hold down the Shift key and notch the left eye one time to the left. Select the right eye, hold down the Shift key and notch it one time to the right. Now zoom out. So now we have the face of the skull and we need to color it and add some shadow for details. So now go to this layer and call it Outline. Then copy the layer by dragging it down here, put the copy below and call this one Color. Now unselect the outline, and on the color layer we want to delete all the details of the face. Now select the outline and make it a fill instead of a stroke. Now select the color you want for the skull. I'll select a light gray. Now we need to add the shadow. So with the shape selected, go to Edit, go to Copy, then go to Edit again and paste in front. Do it one more time. Now we basically have three of these shapes on top of each other. So select the top one, hold down the Shift key and notch it to the right. I will notch it three times to the right. Now keep holding the Shift key and select the layer just below. Now go to the Shape Builder tool, hold down the Alt key to subtract from the shapes and delete the shapes right here. Now we have the shadow. So select the shadow and give it a slightly darker color. Now we have the color and the shadow, but we want to correct the shadow a little bit. As you can see, it doesn't fit quite well right here. So hold down the Shift key and select the tooth, so both the tooth and the shadow is selected. Then go to the Shape Builder tool and delete the shadow right here. If this video was helpful to you, please give it a thumbs up or subscribe to my channel for more of these graphic design tutorials. Thank you for watching.